Hello everyone, welcome to SemiConta. Today, I want to talk about sensors in a smartphone. Do you know how many sensors in your smartphone? Let's list out what they are. Camera, accelerometer, gyroscope, pressure sensor, magnetometer, proximity sensor, ambient light sensor, microphone, touchscreen sensor, heart rate sensor, oximeter, GPS, fingerprint sensor, radar, temperature sensor, humidity sensor, and radiance sensor, and so on. Phew! Did you surprise? Yes, there are a lot of sensors in smartphone, even though most people even don't realize about it. Let's talk about one by one and try to find out what those are. I want to start with cameras. Everyone knows about it, and it is very straightforward. You are right. It takes photos and videos. Inside of camera, there is a tiny semiconductor which converts light into electrical signal. I will try not to use technical terms as much as possible, so please bear with me. Long time ago, most people have cameras to take photos, but now people use their smartphone instead of camera. Why? Because its quality is good enough, and no need to use heavy bulky cameras which is not easy to carry. Next one is accelerometer. It checks change of speed. Actually, check change of speed of your smartphone. What? Why my smartphone need to check that? Do you like to play a game, like car racing game or shooting game? It feels like you are moving with your character, right? Because accelerometer checks change of speed of your smartphone. Did you get it? Good. How about gyroscope? Have you heard about it? Maybe not. It measures rotation, means change of angle. Imagine, you turn steering wheel to the right in your car racing game by turning your smartphone, and your car turned to the right in the game. How? Yep, your gyroscope made it happen for you. Pressure sensor. Pressure sensor? Does my smartphone also check how much pressure I get from my homework? Nope. This pressure is different. You can imagine that it is weight of air. So if you climb a mountain, pressure is decreased because amount of air on top of you will be decreased than less air. So this pressure sensor lets you know how high you climb up. Magnetometer. If you use navigator to find out the place to meet your friend, your smartphone shows big arrow over the map, and it constantly changes direction as you move. Also, if you want to know direction, like which way is north, south, east, or west, you may use compass in your smartphone. Then it tells the right direction. Magnetometer is doing all these work to check magnetic field of Earth. Yes? Of a blue planet Earth, because Earth is a big magnet and generate magnetic field. Proximity sensor. When you got a call, you move your smartphone to your mouth, then your internet surfing screen suddenly turn off. Did you notice that happened? Actually, it is to save your battery, and display use lots of battery power. So it is necessary to save as much as possible to use your smartphone for a long time without charging. How it works? Proximity sensor checks whether your smartphone is close enough from your mouse by emitting infrared light and receiving again. If it is close, means you're on the call. Ambient light sensor. When you move from outside with bright sun to a little bit darker inside a building, your smartphone screen automatically changes brightness to help you to see website or picture better. Also, it can save battery by decreasing brightness of screen in the dark places. This sensor reads the amount of light, then find out its brightness. Microphone. How your smartphone listens when you are talking about. Microphone is about it. And it is a special semiconductor which converts sound into electrical signal. Typically, there are multiple microphones in your smartphone to catch your voice more precisely. touchscreen sensor. How you type in your smartphone? People touch screen by using their fingers. This sensor checks exact location of your fingers on the screen and find out which letter did you type. Amazing, isn't it? Do we still have more sensors? Yes, as I said, there are lots of sensors in your smartphone. We already covered many sensors, so let's continue and explore more about exciting sensors in the next time. Have a nice day and see you again soon.